All right, guys, we'll get started in the next minute or two here. Alright everybody, welcome once again to Clockwork Empires live stream. I'd like to give a shout out to Her Majesty, of course, the Aether, the Holy Cog Empire, and Gaslamp Games, because this game is pretty good so far. This is of course the Steam Early Access build. Not that many options can be changed here. The gameplay, probably not indicative of the final game, but hopefully what you learn and see here today will be transferable to any playthroughs in the future. You might learn a thing or two, or you could enjoy yourself and decide this looks like a great game to buy. So just to let you know, before we go in here, my readings on the forum after the stream yesterday indicated that farming cabbage is quite powerful, and even more importantly, I noted during the stream that it was happening and more people were talking about it, cabbage is the fish people, Johnny Fishman, will stop to destroy cabbages on the way. And so I'm going to set up a field of cabbage shields to keep the evil fishmen from overrunning my colony. We'll see how effective that is using these high-level tactical exploits. So right now, as you can see, just basically selecting large areas, clearing things away, starting with trees and mining some rock. I'm not quite certain what they all are, but I'll take a closer look. Gonna set up some early stockpiles real quick. You do that under zones of constructions, then stockpile. I think a good one to start with, double clicking on it, we'll just do one with building materials. Next one will be just food. Food's gonna be really important. Today, I would certainly like to see a situation where my people are not eating other human bodies. That would be a good ending. We'll do both raw and refined resources, and then finally a just general stockpile. Everything else. And get a graveyard up. And finally, we can see here's the coastline. My experience yesterday taught me that most of the fish folk will be coming directly from the coastline, so I'm gonna get cabbages and other such farms directly between them and the town. These are next level exploits. I'm sure someone else thought of it first, but I'm happy to use it. Let's keep clearing stuff out, giving these people some things to do while we get set up. Now, some notes. This is the internal test build, So under the military, there normally would be an option called patrol, which is okay. You don't want to use patrol. It's terrible and it crashes your game. You probably don't want to click on colonists. That's also crashed my game. Under jobs, you'll see everything that you've assigned so far and who's assigned to it. You want to keep the job list as small as possible. I am so used to, in Dwarf Fortress, just going crazy and assigning hundreds of work orders as soon as the game begins just to clear out large areas, get things flowing. That is not what you want to do with this game. You want to take it piece by piece, slowly. Work crews, you can look over and see what overseers are assigned to do things. And then, of course, we have Her Majesty's Army. We'll look over them shortly, just to get an idea of what the specific jobs they are capable of doing is, and see perhaps if we can more specifically assign them to a role. Next up, we're going to get a carpentry workshop going. Alright. Now, I learned yesterday you can't really revise your buildings after you've built them. It does not work out that well, so I am just going to go ahead and put multiple carpentry workbenches up at the beginning, just to get that out of the way. I don't know what a power saw does, but I'm going to bet we probably have the stuff for it. Nah, we'll keep it out. So there's that. Next up, I have bunkhouse. If you want that to be really big, you're going to need to have a bunch of beds in it just to get your colonists some place to stay somewhat temporarily. You're going to need a lot of wood at the very beginning as well, because it's going to get really expensive to make these cots, and they're going to take a while. So just go ahead, put them down. As you can see, we're still scouting around here with the military, just in general. And move them down there. Let's get another cabbage shield up. That looks good. I'm gonna be swimming in cabbages, which is better than swimming in people eating human flesh. Because as you may know, if you run out of food in this game, your people will start eating dead bodies of fishmen or your fellows. Alright, carpentry workshop's done. So of course, the thing to do would be to order up some planks. Let's look at these work crews. They've got a lot to do right now. They are all looking over things. So this guy is a farmer, and they're both farming, overseer, laborer. Yep, so these little icons here, oh, communist. You know what that means. This guy starts doing communist stuff, we shoot him. Even as an overseer, I cannot tolerate his communism. There's some cult stuff going on here a little bit. There's some strangeness. It's in the game that these events happen, but I've read that currently the cults do nothing but gather together and talk about cults. So it just turns into a circle of culting. I'm sure that when the mechanics become more released, I will be in deep trouble. Oh, there's some sort of crazy, mysterious dark figure stuff. Yeah. My colonies seem to have a lot of culting, so I expect that our Lord Quaggaroth, who sleeps in the depths, will soon overtake the colony. I'm probably pronouncing that name wrong, and someone will correct me shortly. Alright, so just kind of general, I didn't see very many people specialize other than labor, so no need to sub-assign groups. There are a lot of Auroxes here, so we're going to get Her Majesty's most empirical steam scientists with guns to come over here. Going to need to enable hunting jobs, and they're going to unload some gats. Or as they call it, five shots rapid. Yep, that's happening. Although this guy's just walking around. I guess they're done hunting? I don't really know. Sure, I guess. Immigrants! So, in order to assign work crews to thing, you need immigrants and overseers. The more overseers you have, the more tasks you're capable of doing at the same time, and the more people assigned to that task, the theoretical faster it gets done. Theoretical. So I have a bunch of overseers. It's quite nice. I'm just going to take a random group of people and see what arrives. So we've got at least two people and probably a soldier. Yep, new soldier. Not a communist. That's good. We'll get those soldiers back on the front line of the beaches. Who's doing some important stuff? We got cock construction. I really would like that to move faster. So we will... Yep, house is getting built. So next up, kitchen. Definitely need to start cooking all these cabbages. I mean, I don't know if anybody else watches Avatar Last Airbender, but we're doing cabbages like that one guy whose cabbage cart is constantly getting destroyed. Some pro tips from the forums I saw. I normally build a stone oven. However, someone pointed out the second tier small oven is always available. At the very beginning, you'll have what you need to build it. And so I'm just going to go with that this time. And put down two of these. I was told also don't build stuff in corners, as it could screw up the game. I'm gonna attempt to stay away from that in the future as well. We will do materials. Now you saw, perhaps I went past you quickly, there were a couple options. There's food, or guns, or building materials, or nothing. I think food is gonna go pretty well here with all these cabbages and the wheat. We seem to have at least one work crew that's pretty much permanently assigned to farming. So, I think we're good on food. With guns, I mean, everyone that came here already had a gun, and I'm gonna bet that there's probably... No, I don't have one of the steam-powered grenade launchers, but I couldn't use it even if I wanted to. So... Oh, thank you, Alfred. Yes, I think this is going much better than yesterday. I'd like to think that I have learned a thing or two, just like Oregon Trail. So let's clear out some of these rocks here and send out the military to do some more scouting. It's still only the third day, so Johnny Fishman probably won't show up for just a little while longer. I would hate to have to stomp him in the face. Let's see, what kind of rocks are these? So this is just zinc. So we will set up a refinery. Hopefully that's not going to slow us down too much. And I'll probably need to set up a ceramics, although I don't think that I have any clay yet. But hopefully all that materials that the motherland has sent us, God save the queen, and the holy cog, may include some clay. Suppose I could zoom in and check for it. I don't specifically see it out there, but it could be. Just continuing to clear out the area here. Let's get the military back in. These cows are overrunning the populace, so... I know the guys stopped shooting before. Toggle roofs off. If you could tell me how to toggle roofs off, I could tell everyone how to do that and it would look so much better. How do I do that? And there we go. Our brave men and women in red coats standing directly next to Orion Oxes, shooting them in the head. Man, my chat is smart. I need to get good like you guys. Alright, ceramics workshop, just in case. I don't think I have any clay, but I will look for it. Let's get another cabbage shield out here. Just to cover every direction. Middle button top toggle building view. Does that work? Ah, there we go. Science for the queen. So, you know, for those of you not in the know, these are fishman eggs. They are delicious caviar. They feed your population quite well. If you pick them up, the fishmen will come for you. It seems to be proportional, but for a fishman egg clutch of that size, I would guess maybe 10 to 20 will show up. It's a pretty big deal. They really don't like their eggs to be eaten. It's weird. Which is strange because they can't feel pain or emotion. You know, they are a mindless beast, the fishmen. They don't actually have souls either. One more. What other lies can I make up in the name of the queen? Well, I seem to need to make a bigger stockpile, so I'll just make a general purpose one. And maybe these guys will get to hauling. And let's look over these work crews real quick. Seems like people are doing some jobs. Job list is a little longer than I'd like, but we should be good. There's going to be a lot of, obviously, 10 farm jobs, which people can just trade off on. Oh, there's some clay over here, so we got a place to go to when we need it. Get this military. They're all walking away from the rally point for some reason. What are you guys doing? Oh, you crazy military guys. The holy cog is gonna hear this. Here's this guy carrying. Is he gonna plank this power saw up? I think he is. No, he's just gonna make some carpentry. Alright, okay. I can deal with it. Hello, Llama Player 5, whose name might be Iama Player. How are you today? Let's clear out these coastal trees, because the fishmen like to hide in this general area along the coast. They'll come out of the water, and sometimes it can be difficult to see them. More immigrants. I will take 3 of anything and see what I get. 3 workers, a miner, farmer, and metal worker. So, oh, fishmen! You can see them! They're coming! They are coming right now! It's happening. There are the fishmen. Where's the military? Oh, they're going the wrong way. Only my cabbages can protect me and a man with a gun. Never stop shooting. Excellent. Excellent. All right. The boys are taking them. 5 shots rapid. Can we defeat them? This seems fair. 3-on-1. Pistols. Alright, I think we're missing one. There he is. One of my soldiers is just walking in circles. What is it? What are you doing over here? Of course he's going to eat food. He's a communist.
Oh.
All right. Let's see if we can intercept him and deploy the Queen's most holy gospel, cog, etc., etc. And he's dancing. He won't be dancing for very long. That was pretty quick. It's only like day four? Already talking about cults? Alright. So you can see I put up too many job orders at once. They're still working on this other stuff right now. So don't do what I just did. Definitely try to take it a little slower here. And apparently I have too many farms because they're not being tended to well. So next time the option comes up, I'm going to order some more oversteers. Ah yes, the save game feature. Well, I've enabled the internal tests. I was able to save successfully yesterday, and after 3 tries I could load. As they say, a lot of people requested a save game. No one asked to have the game be loaded. Which only goes to show the developers have quite a good sense of humor. Which I can appreciate, because I am wearing a hat. For those of you who haven't been here before, please follow on Twitch, or like and subscribe on YouTube. On top of these streams for Clockwork Empires, which I'll be doing every time there's a significant release, I also have normal scheduling for Pathfinder for Dungeons & Dragons. And I'm thinking that when Civilizations 5 Beyond, or I'm sorry, what is it called now? Civilizations Beyond Earth? When that gets released, I will probably begin streaming that. Here are the fishfolk. Not so good. Got a lot of citizens out on the front lines while my men are out scouting. Hopefully these cabbage plants might save them. We may see the cabbage in action. Will he stop to destroy the cabbages? He will not. The madman. We will continue chasing him. We will never allow the fishmen to succeed. I think that's all 3 of them.
Oh.
Let me know if anybody sees any other ones. Unfortunately, the whole town is probably going to be upset because they were assaulted by fishmen. And these fields are definitely dying out. Let's check in with the kitchen. Oh, they made a bunch of stew already. Alright, see, yesterday I was having a lot of trouble with the stewing. But I got an oven, and I got 2 workbenches, so I am stewing like a pro. For some reason it says that this kiln is finished, and yet it is still outlined. I don't know if that's a bug or not. So let's set up some brick.
Oh.
And a couple more planks with my already overtaxed population. And just real quick, because these Auroxes are everywhere, we're just gonna come in for a clean sweep and shoot them in the face using the hunting option. Considering all the things that currently need to be done, I'm surprised at the number of overseers that have no job. I don't really get that, but... I'm being told that the materials for the kiln have been delivered, but someone actually has to finish the job, which is probably why all of these lazy bums are sitting around doing nothing. And I never actually signed any of these immigrants who arrived. One of them was a miner who I really wanted to specifically sign to a party. There's the miner, and here is the farmer. This crew seems to be farming currently. We'll try to get a mining specific group going down at some point. For now, let's see here. So we will disiction and stuff for these guys, and for these two, this should turn them into kind of like permanent haulers, farmers. Let's do the complete opposite for the first group that has lots of people in it. We'll just turn them into only workers. We will see if that works out. It probably will not. Oh, I'm being attacked by fishfolk while I'm not looking. Will they stop for the cabbages? No. The cabbage field exploit is not successfully deployed. But at least my people are not starving. So I ordered up a new overseer, who I will assign some fellows to. And let's make her team a specialist job as well. Yeah, I have noticed that overseers have a tendency to like to go dancing and cause their whole crew to do nothing. That's why you need lots and lots of overseers to get around the dancing. So, let's see. I had a bunch of zinc sitting around, so let's see if we can do that. How is stew production going? Not at all. Stew production has stopped. Oh, no, there's someone making stew right now. Alright, well, somebody got on it. Turn a lot of this raw wood into something less raw. There's a bunch of skeletons around here as well, so hopefully we can... What was it you needed to do? Forage them? There we go. Now that's a lot of jobs right now going up. Hopefully everyone can tend to these. And we'll just wait a little while and see what happens. So, yesterday, as you might know, we got up to 30 days, and I believe 29 citizens at the highest, and 8 prestige. I'm hoping to easily break that. The goal today has been to show you guys the basics. I think we have swimmingly done the basics here of just the most lowest mechanical level. I'm hoping to get the full industry going on all the way up to firearms and alcohol. Fish people are attacking again. They're keeping it kind of small. That's nice. I'm a little concerned because they seriously seem to only come from the ocean to directly where your airship landed, so you can kind of funnel them into the area like this. Alright. So you're just stationing your military in one spot. But maybe it's just because the military has such terrible AI mechanics. They do it just so your military gets there in time and actually fights them. Hard to say. It sounds like they have some really cool ideas for what they're going to do with the military. They just haven't implemented it yet. Alright, we got some farming teams out here. Just farming cabbages. My cabbages! No problem. If you want to add me on Steam, I have absolutely no issue with that. Okay. Jobs list looks good. The work crews, there's probably two that aren't assigned. One, two. Yep, two. Getting pretty good at reading this jobs list. A solid wall of buildings on the side facing the ocean. That does sound like a good idea. Except, well, I guess people do shoot through buildings, but they can't walk through them? That's a pretty good hacksplate. I would suggest that as well, and maybe I'll try that out. I saw people trying to use numerological buildings, or I'm probably saying it wrong. They were attempting to make, like, Cthulhu-type buildings with unusual shapes and ridiculous architecture. It was pretty fun. So, just need some more overseers here to get these jobs done. Really, the basics of the colony involve so much farming to keep the food supply going that it's hard to support much else. We do have... is this... oh, no, instead of working, the overseer is, of course, admiring fine machinery. Now, there's nothing wrong with worshipping the holy cog, and of course, she is a holy cog worshipper. But it is much better when you actually do work, rather than just look at things. Yeah, I guess maybe it's just my ADD kicking in, but I really want to assign so many more tasks, but I know it's going to overload all of my people. So sometimes you just have to relax, sit back, and just kind of wait for something to happen. Can't always be on the go here. But just to explain my plan for the next couple of minutes, I'd like to get up a middle-class house. I don't know. I haven't asked anybody. I haven't heard anything along the lines. I'd like to get the middle-class house up just so that if there are middle-class citizens, like I would guess the overseers perhaps, they will have the option of using it and enjoying themselves. And the refinery is up. But also need a metalworks. And the metalworks is that last step before the brewery, I think. And then get up an arsenal and a chemist shop. We will see. And then, for those of you that are waiting for it, I will at some point begin eating all the fishmen eggs and causing them to attack in mass. Because why not? Losing is fun. Zinc, zinc, zinc. Man, I need to make a lot of zinc. This place is zinc-tastic. Do I need to make charcoal first? Is that what it is? I'll try that. I got plenty of wood, so why not? Throw up an overseer here, just to get some more subdivided tasks. Who's the one that's never doing anything? Philomena Robin. I'm gonna take away most of your workers here. Yeah, because I don't like you. You've been standing around dancing for like 2 days. I heard a couple shots go off. I'm guessing a couple fishermen might have attacked. I don't see anything now, though. Well, it looks like it's time to start expanding the jobs menu, because people people are not doing things. No one is making bricks. Oh, you know why they're not breaking bricks? Because I never actually mined that clay. So that is not their fault. It is entirely on me. Let us get some clay over here. We have plenty of trees, so let's get some berries. And some more ore. That looks like hematite. And that will mean iron. Oops, I just clicked dismantle. I'm pretty sure I did. Hopefully they don't dismantle anything. Another thing, don't click renovate. It doesn't work, and it might crash your game, so don't touch it. If you want to have multiple things in your workshop so they can do lots of stuff at the same time, you want to do that on the front end when you build it. So stew's going along, nobody's getting hungry. I haven't even had to order food. Did I leave hunting on for... Yeah, that's why. There's occasional shots. Plenty of food to go around. People aren't attempting to eat dead bodies. All in all, it's been a good time so far. What do you guys think? Are you enjoying Cogs Bronze the Overseer? The default name you get in New Antipodea? I can't wait to see Idols of Quaggaroth. Yes, you should avoid touching things to prevent the game from crashing, because it will happen quite often. Do not attempt to renovate. Ever. You also can't cancel jobs, I believe, so don't try to do that either. Oh, the stew is being made at a generally good clip. I think it's enough to feed the citizens, and of course there's huge bushels of cabbage. Oh, sure, yeah, it's less enjoyable when your citizens aren't eating the dead fishmen and each other. Sure. Oh, speaking of fishmen, he's just randomly dancing down here. As the announcer says, it's time to take on Johnny Fishman. No, I'm sorry. I don't mean to confuse you, Llama Player. Not touching trees, just generally touching the buttons in the workshop up top, like dismantle and renovate and all that. They don't work, and don't touch them because you might crash. And with no saves, no crash means really bad stuff. I like how they shot him twice after he was already dead. So, of course, Miss Philomena Robin is still doing nothing but admiring things. I guess I better just allow her to do whatever. Is that what the problem is? Did she claim this workshop and then she didn't have this construction or... Yeah, that's what it is. Oh, jeez. I should have paid more attention to the chat down there. So bad. Hopefully in the future, they'll make it so that when overseers have limited jobs, they aren't assigned buildings that they can't actually use. But for now, you'll just have to keep an eye on it. My bad for not catching that. Oh, the clay mining is beginning. And look, we got some bushels of fungus. Delicious. So we're gonna set up a couple homes, but really these are just to be used as shields against the invading fishermen. I'm gonna put the door on the far side so they have to walk around. However, as I have noted, your soldiers will shoot through the sides of buildings. And apparently they can sit down in chairs and eat things, so I'm gonna put some chairs. Just so that they have some fun, you know? Just keep it loose, keep it fancy. Eat some things in a chair. Who doesn't love chairs? People who don't worship the holy cog, that's who. You can see right-clicking, you can change the direction these are pointing in. I'm not going to be able to get a solid line, but maybe I can make things uncomfortable and force the fishermen to walk in strange directions. That's not going to work at all. Hopefully canceling doesn't crash the game. So how is the industries of the colony going? Going to need some more wood. Plenty of raw material to go around there. Charcoal. Is she really just standing there again? Still admiring. Fine machinery! I hate you, Philomena, so much. It says that her job is to make charcoal. I mean, I guess, is this other person making charcoal? Oh, thank goodness. Someone and this facility is on the job. So we got some stew, we got some other stuff. I will go with 3 of anything, just to see if I get lucky. Another military commander would be nice. No, I did not get what I wanted, or did I? I don't think so. It seems like I only got one person. Maybe they got auto-assigned. So who's doing some important jobs? Tending some crops? Well, there's plenty of crops to be tended, so... Guess what, buddy? Oops, that's not what I wanted to do at all. You're a miner. Well... You're tending crops for now. I thought I had plenty of raw wood. But if not, I can begin Operation Deforestation. I mean, yeah, like, look over here. Like, this whole area is nothing but raw wood. Maybe I just need bigger stockpiles of raw wood. We'll try that, see if that works out. How is Team Kitchen doing? Team Kitchen's doing quite fine. So we're stewing. No one has started butchering the fishermen yet, I think. Their corpses are still lying around. I don't see them anymore, so maybe someone did. But at least no one is walking down to the beach, cutting them up and eating them raw. At least if they're being turned into stew, I feel a little bit better about it. Some more raw material. We have clay, which means we can make some bricks. Oh no! Oh, please don't crash! Don't do it, I'm so close to being ready to make it to the next level. My heart is breaking. See if I can throw some zinc smelting on here at the same time. I have not attempted this. This is some next level tactics. Can Philomena Robin smelt some ingots at the same time as her assistant is making charcoal? Will it work? I don't know. We'll find out. Stew is happening. My military apparently decided to walk around for no apparent reason. Let's get them back on the front lines, just in case. Fishmen haven't attacked for a little while, so we might be due. Oh, and there we go. That happened. My heart is broken. We'll give it one more shot here, guys. Would have been a good time to use the new save feature, indeed.
Oh.
I thought I was going to crash when I started getting that error message. I don't know if you guys caught it, but it said something like, FSM sleep disabled, something, something. Chunk these down. So we're back to basics again. For those of you that... What? Fishman already? Well, that's nuts. Wow. This world has come pre-spawn with fishmen on the beach. For those of you that were watching, just to learn how the game is played, maybe see if you like it. I am, of course, using one of the test clients, which could break. I knew that going in. You yourself, if you are enjoying things, now would be a good time to purchase the game. I hope I do not lose a military guy right here. Oh, he's dead. Oh, thank goodness. More fishmen! Wow. I don't know what is happening here. Has this happened to anyone else before? I mean, I've made probably six games and I've never seen fishmen on spawn. But, I can't keep microing these guys. We gotta get down to brass tacks. Storage. So, walking back through the basics. Okay, now we've got, just have the speed general pile. Wow, fish folk are coming left and right. What is this madness? Oh no, someone's walking right into the camp. Oh, this is nuts. I've never seen it like this. Come on, military. Hop, hop, for the queen. Five rounds rapid. Excellent. All right. So, let's get farms going. Oh, geez, is there another one over here? Hut to it. They are all over the place. You know what? Maybe the devs saw me talking about the fishmen only coming from one direction and secretly uploaded just to make them come from every direction. I like that conspiracy theory. It fits with the whole mythos. So, let's get some food production down. Again, we're doing food production quite early, just so that we don't end up eating our own dead. Sounds like fun, really is not. and let's get some housing going. We will use the strategy that has been suggested, where we use the houses as barricades against the incoming and tidal invaders. So, just an entrance on the far side, and begin setting up cots everywhere. And then we are putting in a carpentry workshop, of course, to make all that cut wood that we currently require. And no reason not to make a bunch of workbenches, because I might end up with a crew of 3 or 4 people working on it, and there will be plenty of wood. Throw in a power saw. Let's see. Over here. And a desk, just to be fancy. And let's start the deforestation over here. What was that movie in the 90s where the bad guy was like a crane? And it was all about bats and stuff. Fern Gully, maybe? It's a good movie. That crane was my hero. Alright, so the jobs, there should be quite a few. Yeah, that construct cot is going to take up a lot of places. It's more jobs than I would like. But hopefully these guys will take them piece by piece and slowly begin finishing them. So as you can see, we are of course fertilizing our cabbages with raw fishmen. You know, once they get ripe, after a couple days or so, the fishmen dissolve directly into the cabbage and add just a soupçon of flavor, just what you need in the morning when you get a nice cabbage. This is a fisherman just walking around again. Man, I cannot get rid of the guys this time. Here are the people. Hopefully you don't run in terror. Nope, it's just my military running in terror this time. As the rest of them walk around doing absolutely nothing. Alright, well at least he punched that guy to death. Yes, I have been told, as Chad is talking about, stew is usually the best way to go. I mean, pretty much anything can be used for stew. Anything. Speaking of stew, well, I'll wait for, as requested, let's turn these things off so we can see inside. A good idea. More fishmen! He's attacking the cabbages! Operation Cabbage has worked! Placing them in the wrong direction. However, by putting these fields at the outskirts of your town, the fishfolk will attack them instead of the citizens. This is all good news as the military comes to respond. However, my precious wheat is gone, but the cabbages are still intact. I repeat, the cabbages are intact. I'm just gonna expand the view here a little because I am used to fishmen only coming from one direction and this multi-fishman attack walking directly out of the fog of war is really throwing me off. I guess they're not even spawning, they've just already been placed on the map. Fight you devils! Alright, so I think food supply is going to be great with all these cabbages. I'm going to request materials. Now, I did some research yesterday, as you might have heard. I was checking out some of the blogs. They call it Secession Games. I know it as Bloodline Games from Dwarf Fortress, but they fully intend to support that multiplayer system, wherein you will play through a certain amount of time and then send the save file to the next person in line. Everyone writes their little fan fictions or just simple write-ups. I like to give some personality to my people. I would, of course, take this overseer of Philomena Robin from the last game and make fun of her a lot. Wow, there are a ton of frickin' eggs right here. I mean, that's like a 20, 30 fishman attack worth of eggs. I am gonna eat those eggs. In keeping with the movie references today, I would like to remind everyone of the next favorite villain in line. I think it's Land of Time 3, where the Velociraptor has a song about eggs. A defining moment for the generation. If you ain't eating eggs, you're a loser. That's right, we get exactly this nerdy. We keep it real how nerdy this is. Okay, I hear shooting. This is bad. That's some impressive uphill shooting. I don't think that would be really possible, but sure. Alright. So it does seem as if instead of normal, the fishmen are not coming from one direction, they are spawning in many directions or they're already on the map. It's going to make things a little bit more difficult. Let's check in with the crew, see how things are going. Planks are being made, cots are being made. Let's throw up a kitchen. Job list is mostly just the same jobs over and over again. So someone will get around to it eventually. I saw some clay in the area, so it's looking like ceramic making is definitely going to be possible. I'm being told that fishmen by default spawn on the map. I had not seen that before. I will take your word for it, however. Press X. Oh my goodness, I don't know what happened. Can you explain to me what has happened? Is this like thermal imaging? Am I the predator now? Fog of War, so, oh, well, that's some hacksploit. Yep, I can see all the fishmen. Wow, there's a lot over here. Alright, it's time. This is happening. 5 rounds rapid. We'll come back over there in a second just to see how it goes down. That's some hacksploit, though. I approve. Kitchen's going down. Might as well throw down that ceramics workshop. next to the big pile of clay. You can see this time, at least for the workshops, I've been going for a lot more depth than normal, just making a bunch of stuff rather than one or two. I don't know if the fruit bunches replenish in time. I'm pretty sure that trees regrow themselves, however. Alright, this is happening. They got some clay over here, so let's just assume I've come to kill the fish people for their clay resources. That makes sense. We're missing at least one fighter, however. I don't want to take on like 9 fishmen with only 2 people. But my men are not turning around. They will not stop until we encounter this fistfolk. I believe that these brave men are about to walk directly into their deaths. Yep, this is the big group of them. It's happening. How many can we kill before all these men die? Oh, well, those two basically just keeled over, so, I mean. Here we got some immigration. We'll take another overseer to get some more jobs done. What is happening? I see beatings going on. Oh, they're just beating each other. Okay, the military has won. We are victorious over Johnny Fishman. We will continue to pursue them. We shall fight them on the beaches. We shall fight them on the plains. Apparently we won't. Apparently we'll walk around in circles. That's cool too. Go home and get some rest, guys. All this raw material is still just sitting out. I don't know what to think about that. Saskatonberry bushes in the game. Find them on the higher ground. Well, we will certainly look for them if we have time. I'm being attacked by fish people, and my military is far afield. So, we will have to rely on our superior cabbage farming. Oh, here's the one person that sat in town and did nothing. Alright, come on, General. Pop a gat. Here's this guy. What's your problem? Drop tool! You're the tool! Stop walking around and start shooting! How will this epic fight end? Pretty unepically, but in victory. Did he just put his weapon down as the fish folk is running up? Oh, this is so bad. So bad. Nope, and that was the military overseer, too. Yep, things just went from bad to literally the worst they could possibly be. I no longer have direct control of my military. It's real now. Alright. I guess I just assign these guys to random work crews and hope like heck that they pull out their weapons and shoot people. When you get in a situation like this, you need to go when the immigration is offered, instead of looking for an overseer, you're just going to have to take a chance on the three random people and hope one of them is a military overseer. Because otherwise, you just stay in complete and utter despair like this. Oh, and it has crashed again. I think that is that, ladies and gentlemen. I do not seem to be able to get farther ahead than this with this test build. Perhaps on the next release, I will once again attempt the quest for beer. Hopefully, in learning this, you have had fun and maybe learned a thing or two. Hopefully, you'll purchase the game. Let me throw this up here. If you enjoyed this, perhaps like to see more of it in the future, please follow me here on Twitch or Twitter or on YouTube. Please like and subscribe. I will still be available in the chat for the next few minutes, so if you are here live, please take the opportunity to speak with me. Thank you all for showing up, and may our Lord Quaggaroth reign in his eternal fishiness. All hail Johnny Fishman.